Hello, I'm Liz Lumley of The Banker, and this is The View from Cybos. And today I'm speaking to Francesca Nenci, Global Head of Trade at UniCredit. Hello, Francesca, how are you?
Hello, Elisabetta. Very well, thank you.
Excellent. So we're going to talk a little bit about digital transformation. Of course, many parts of the bank, the industry are seeing lots of digital transformation projects right at the moment, and of course it's no surprise they're bleeding into the corporate and the transaction banking space. How are these projects unique from similar efforts that kind of maybe started in the retail space?
Thanks, Elizabeth. Let's start from what they have in common, and that I think it's very important to understand when we are speaking about digitalization. Digitalization, or better, as you said, digital transformation, it's not only about technology or disruption. It is the cultural, organizational, and operational change of an organization. According to me, it's about value, people, optimization, and the capability to rapidly adapt when such is needed through an intelligent use of technology and information. This is common to every digital project. Having said that, each business is different and has different needs. Let's take the transaction banking you were mentioning, and more specifically, the trade finance business. According to the ICC data, 80% of world trade relies on trade finance services. By providing liquidity and cash flow and lowering, in the meantime, the risk, trade finance simply ensure that the importers receive their goods and the exporter receive their payment. So, Elizabeth, you can easily understand the importance of this business for the real economy. But on the other end, what we need to know is that trade finance is a highly paper-based business in which paper documents represent the commercial framework of the entire transaction, which involve numerous stakeholders. To give you some numbers, every year, 4 billion of pages are handled all over the world in order to perform a trade finance transaction. And for each transaction, we have from 30 to 50 actors involved, 30, 35 original documents required, and 80 pages per transaction. So, digitalization of trade finance is not only a project, it's a real digital journey where, in order to ensure the sustainability of this business and meet our client needs, you have not only to digitalize your product offering, but also you need to digitalize your internal operational process. In UniCredit, we are at the heart of this digital transformation for trade finance, with, on one end, our digital bank customer digital channel, the name is Trade Finance Gate, and on the other, our internal process that is now completely based on new technology as optical recognition character and the artificial intelligence. These solutions are allowing us to improve our client experience, simplify as much as possible the interaction with us, and also reducing the operational risk, offering better and quicker services to our clients, and focusing our trade finance operators' time on value-added services for our clients instead of manual data input.
No, it's fascinating. It's so interesting how so much of digital transformation involves emerging technologies like artificial intelligence, but also getting through that paper mountain that you mentioned as well. It's interesting. So, I mean, as the bank works with your corporate clients, how do you make sure that they're on the same digital transformation journey as the bank?
In a very simple way, Elizabeth, we are speaking with our clients every day. We are hearing their needs. In trade finance, the product function is basing every digital new product or enhancement to the existing ones on our client needs and requests. We always work together. Let's take the Trade Finance Gate, for example, the digital channel I was mentioning you before. With the Trade Finance Gate, now treasurers today can digitally send the importer of credit, can submit a request for outgoing guarantees, for LC export, for the utilization of import letter of credit. They can build their own inquiries and reports and even open guarantees using predefined templates for a fast and efficient documentation processing. Trade Finance Gate today is able to give to the treasurer the possibility to sign docs online rather than have to print, sign, scan and send them on or even bringing these physically to the branch. It is live since 2019, but since then it was enriched every time in order to respond to our customer needs. So it's a continuous work in progress with client workshop, client testing, and a lot of other activities to be sure that our product offering evolves together with our clients' needs. As I said before, it is a journey where we need to embark together to reach the most important result, empowering our communities to progress, grow, and rebuild. In UniCredit, moreover, we have a new digital division in place, and more details about the group's digital strategy as a whole will be given at the next Investor Day.
Interesting. Excellent. Francesca, thank you so much for sitting down with me. Thank you.
Thank you, Elizabeth.